So students, let's continue next part of chapter David Copperfield. Mr. Creakle called me into his office and said, "I know Mr. Murdstone well. He has told me that you bite people. Be careful, young man. No biting here in my school. When I tell you to obey, you obey. Or else..." I knew what he meant. I felt very frightened. Days, weeks and months passed. I hated every day at Salem House. So in this stanza, the meeting between David Copperfield and Mr. Creakle is told. Mr. Creakle, who was the headmistress of the school where David was sent, told David that he should be careful and he should not bite the people. Because actually Mr. Murdstone told Mr. Creakle that David bites people, but actually he never bit. A visit from Mr. Peggotty and Ham cheered me up. They brought me news about little Emily Peggotty and my mother. Then came the end of the term and the holidays and my return home. So when David was living at Salem House, he didn't like any day there. He hated every day. But whenever Mr. Peggotty and Ham came to meet him, then he was feeling very happy. And after the end of the term, when the holiday started, he returned home. When he returned home, the coach from London dropped me off at Blunderstone. I walked up the garden path towards my home. I went into the sitting room and I find my mother sitting by the fire with the baby in her arms. So when after the holidays, after the term ended, David went to his home, he saw that his mother gave a birth to a baby. It was a baby boy actually. My mother was happy to see me. "He's your brother, David," she said, holding up the baby. Peggotty came running in. "Master Davy, oh Davy," she said, hugged me happily. So when Ham went there, when David went there, then his mother received him and his mother introduced him to his little brother, and Peggotty was very happy to meet him, and she came and hugged him. The holidays were soon over and I had to leave. As the cart began to move, so here these lines are very important actually. As the cart began to move, my mother came to the gate. She stood there